So let me show you a little trick to create some nice arpeggios. So we have this progression here, G minor 7, C 7, F major 7, B flat major 7, E minor 7 flat 5, A 7 to D minor 7. So over the G minor 7, I use F major 7 and G minor 7. So I take the parallel chord from the scale. Okay, so here F major 7 is a good choice. So I play this arpeggio here and go down G minor 7. So up F major 7, down G minor 7. And the next chord is the C7 chord. Here I take E minor 7 flat 5 and D minor 7. So I play this E minor 7 flat 5 and this D minor 7 arpeggio here. Okay. And for the F major 7, I use G minor 7 and F major 7 together. So now I start from the E and then down G minor 7, where I start from the B flat and go down. So the arpeggio is here. Okay, so and for the B major 7 chord, which are the next chord, I use A minor and A minor 7 and B major 7. And I start the arpeggio from E here, so the A, we have the A minor 7 here. So I start from E. So I play and so and then B flat major 7. I have this arpeggio here. So I play from E first, the A minor 7, and then B flat major 7. Yeah, and the next chord is the E minor 7 flat 5. Here I choose E minor 7 flat 5 with D minor 7. So, yeah, so E minor 7 flat 5 and D minor 7 arpeggio for this chord. And for the A7, I take a chord from another scale because it's a scale which fits very good to this, and it's from the D. Oh, sorry, the D harmonic minor scale. And on the flat 6 degree, we have B flat. So if we create a chord from the scale tones, get this D flat major 7 chord, but I will not go into that now in this lesson here. I will just show you which chords are great to use. So B flat major 7 and A7 together over the A7 is very good when we have a minor 5, 2, 5, 1 minor. Yeah. So let me show you what I play here. So the A7. And then B flat major 7, so. And then you can hear the scale.